Hello friends, welcome to TechQuest channel. This is Father Tech by Your Tech. In this video, we are going to discuss about thyroid hormone synthesis and regulation. The hormone synthesis is very important part to understand the regulation and the blood test done to identify the disease conditions. The butterfly-shaped thyroid gland is located just inferior to the larynx. Microscopic thyroid follicles make up most of the thyroid gland. The thyroid gland is the only endocrine gland that stores its secretory product in large quantities, normally about 100 days supply. Synthesis of thyroid hormones. Iodine trapping thyroid follicle cells trap iodine ions by actively transporting them from blood into the cytosol. Thyroid glands contains most of the iodine in the body. Thyroglobin. Thyroid follicular cells also produce a large glycoprotein, thyroglobin, and release to the lumen. The trapped iodine also passes through the cell membrane into the lumen of follicle. As iodine molecules form, they react with the tyrosine amino acid that are part of thyroglobin molecules. Binding of one iodine atom yields monoiodothyrosine, that is T1, and a second iodination produces diiodothyrosine, T2. The thyroglobulin attached with iodine atom is stored in the lumen of thyroid follicle is called colloid. During last step, two diiodothyrosine, that is T2, molecules join to form T4, and one T1 and one T2 joins to form T3. They diffuse through the plasma membrane into the interstitial fluid and into the blood. Transport. More than 99% of both the T3 and T4 combine with transport proteins in the blood, mainly thyroxine binding globulin, TBG, transthyretin or tyrosine binding prealbumin, TBPA, human serum albumin and lipoproteins. The functions are to ensure constant supply to the cells, preventing from urinary loss, prevents changes in thyroid hormones and the target amount of hormone delivery. 75% of T4 is bound to thyroxine binding globulin and 20% to thyroxine binding prealbumin. 75% of T4 is bound to thyroxine binding globulin and 20% to human serum albumin. Thyroxine binding globulin carries major part of T3 and T4 and reverse T3, and therefore quantitative and qualitative changes in thyroxine binding globulin concentration have a high impact on total T3 and T4 levels. Transthyretin. Thyroxine binding prealbumin binds only about 15-20% of circulating thyroid hormone, has lower affinity to hormones, thus it dissociates fast for immediate delivery to cells. Transthyretin is the major transport protein for CSF. Human serum albumin binds about 5% of circulating T3 and T4. It has lower affinity to thyroid hormones and associated with many other enzymes. The fluctuating levels have no effect on thyroid hormone levels. Free T4 is the primary product of the normal thyroid gland. When T4 undergoes deiodination of one iodine, the outer ring at 5' position, it yields T3. When the inner ring deiodination occurs, it yields reverse T3. Reverse T3 is metabolically inactive and an end product of T4. Deiodination is the rapidly responsive metabolism control for thyroid hormone balance. Acute or chronic stress, illness, and some medications can shift the peripheral deiodination towards the inactive product of reverse T3. In the liver, T3 and T4 are conjugated to form sulfates and glucuronates and enter the bile, pass into intestine. The thyroid conjugates are hydrolyzed and some are reabsorbed and some are excreted in the stool. Functions of thyroid hormone. Controls the metabolism, regulates body vital functions, breathing, heart rate, central and peripheral nervous system, body weight, muscle strength, menstrual cycles, body temperature, cholesterol level, regulates oxygen consumption, stimulates protein synthesis and increase the use of glucose and fatty acids for ATP production. Together with human growth hormone and insulin, accelerate body growth, particularly the growth of the nervous and skeletal system. Regulation of thyroid hormones. Thyrotropin releasing hormone, that is TRH, from the hypothalamus, and thyroid stimulating hormone TSH from the anterior pituitary stimulates synthesis and release of thyroid hormones. Low blood levels of T3 and T4 and low metabolic rate stimulates the hypothalamus to secrete thyrotropin releasing hormone. The thyrotropin releasing hormone enters anterior pituitary and stimulates thyrotropes to secrete thyroid stimulating hormone. Thyroid stimulating hormone stimulates all aspects of thyroid follicular cells activity to increase in iodine dropping, hormone synthesis and secretion, and growth of follicular cells. The thyroid follicular cells release T3 and T4 into the blood until the metabolic rate returns to normal. An elevated level of T3 and T4 inhibits release of thyrotropin release hormone and thyroid stimulating hormone by negative feedback inhibition. The negative feedback is similar to thermostat in daily life used in geysers, iron boxes, and in air conditions. Thanks for watching. Please watch, share, and subscribe TechQuest channel and watch my other videos for blood tests. Thank you.